of the individuals the Torah tells us should not go out to war is he who is fearful of sin. And the Gemara identifies this person and says, you know, the person who has sinned, they're obviously going to be scared because if they're out to war, it's very dangerous. But the question the Gemara asks is, what sin is this person so scared of that he's committed that he's going to be punished on the battlefield? And one of the answers the Gemara gives is fascinating. It's dealing with the person who interrupted between putting on his tefillin shel yad and his tefillin shel rosh. Someone who just has a conversation or has a break in his concentration between that very holy act. And so we might ask ourselves, is that really such a tragic sin? We always try to do everything as well as we can. We try to do everything perfectly. But if we have a slight break in our concentration between tefillin shel yad and tefillin shel rosh, is that really so bad? So some of the commentators explain that this is really reminiscent. It really reflects something much deeper. The shel yad, the tefillin that we put on our hands, it represents our actions. The tefillin shel rosh, it represents our aspirations, our thoughts. And the problem with having a break between the two is that sometimes we have very high aspirations, but we sometimes neglect to reflect those aspirations in our actions. And says the Gemara, that individual who is hypocritical, that their thoughts are high, but their actions are low, that person is fearful. So this is a challenge for all of us to not only aspire high, but to do our best to bring those aspirations into fruition. Have a wonderful Shabbos.